Let's do a very quick data science chalk talk to try to undo some of the questions I left open in some of my earlier talks. So basically, back to the idea of scoring or criticizing or computing the loss for, loss being a criticism, regression or numeric models. Now, when I last left off, we had a bunch of metrics based on the SSE, which if basically YI is the ith value you're trying to predict, and VI is your ith prediction, and you want these to be very close, the SSE criticism is just a sum over all n instances you have in your set, be it a training set, test set, or future application data set, and every bit of this little formula has a name. So this difference is called the error or the residual. This is the squared error, and this is the sum of squared errors, hence SSE. Now, the problem is the SSE, well, it's not a huge problem. The SSE is a great metric. However, for you and I, mere humans, we don't understand the scale or the units of it because it's in square units, so it's not in the units of the original problem, and it sums over an entire data set, so it's not obvious whether 100 SSE is a big number or a small number. So there's no expectations. Now, we had another metric that was very important, the RMSE, and that is really just 1 over n SSE quantity square root. And you can read that, it's the error squared mean rooted. Root mean square error. So this is a great metric. It's back into your original units. If YI and VI are in dollars, RMSE is in dollars, and it's independent of data set size because it divided by the number of rows, converting the sum to a mean. So this is a great metric, and it's in your domain units. So if you're a real estate agent, you know whether an RMSE of $10,000 is large or small. So this solves a lot of problems. However, if you're not a domain expert, if you're a mere data scientist, then you also might want a dimensionless metric or criticism. That way you have some idea, big and small, independent of the domain. Now, one metric we talked about for that was the R squared metric. And I've probably said too much on that already, but its virtue is it's a dimensionless metric. So here's another dimensionless metric that maybe makes a lot of sense to use. I don't know what the standard name of it is, but it's basically, let's call it the relative RMSE. And let's just define it as so it's basically how small is your RMSE compared to somebody else's RMSE. And in particular, notice that this other prediction is not subscripted with an I, which means we have to use the same prediction for every data row. The most obvious thing to put in there is Y bar, which is 1 over n sum I equals 1 to n YI. So this is now a dimensionless quantity because we divided two things with the same units by each other, therefore it's dimensionless. So if this was in dollars and this is in dollars, this is in an abstract unit. What is a desirable value for the relative RMSE? It's zero. We would like that to be zero. What is the RMSE of something that is no better than guessing the grand mean, which is our barrier for uselessness? Because even if you don't know the mean, treating all the data as identical, which is what you do if you don't have a model, behaves like that. So what is the barrier for uselessness? It's a relative RMSE of 1. And what is being even worse than not knowing the advice, actually having bad advice, it's an RMSE, relative RMSE exceeding 1. I believe one could quickly explain the relative RMSE to an audience and use it. And you don't run into any problems that there's pedagogical reasons that R squared is supposedly only for nested models on training data, a position I strongly disagree with. However, now you're not, at least not even making that argument. However, you are making the really bad show of using a non-standard metric, which is bad and good. It means you have to explain it. But frankly, for a heterogeneous audience, you always need to explain everything lightly anyway. So this is not as bad a thing as you'd think. Anyway, so that's just my mini data science chalk talk on evaluating regression or number predicting models. And I'm thinking I'm going to start using the relative RMSE more and more. And it's basically, it has an interpretation. Zero is perfection. One is you're leaving as much error on the table as just using the mean. And larger than that is you're worse than useless. And so you can say things like, hey, a relative RMSE of 0.1 seems small. It's 1/10 of the error rate in natural units, in dimensionless version of that, than not knowing the answer. So I'm kind of excited about that. Anyway, hopefully you see data science as a set of tools you can decide to use or not use. And of course, I assume you're using them all correctly, but not as a set of rules you're needed to avoid or obey. And basically, make it your own, teach your variation to others, and you will look confident. Thank you.